Okay, so I'd like to construct a truth table for the compound proposition. Well, if Q, then not P, if and only if P, if and only if Q. It's almost too difficult to try to express in words. It makes so much more sense like this, doesn't it? And so this is a pretty complicated biconditional that we have to make a truth table for. But as usual with truth tables, all we have to do is break it down into component parts. It's kind of atomic parts. We know that I only have P's and Q's in here, and so my first column and my second column are all the truth values for P and Q respectively, and I've written them out in such a way so that it's easy for me to check to make sure I've hit all the possible permutations of true and false. Okay, so the first column is really easy. If I have, all I have to do is negate P. Well, if P is true, then of course not P is false. And if P is false, not P is true. That's super easy. Now I have this conditional, if Q, then not P. Now notice, let's take a break and notice what, you know, why I wrote all these different columns. I say all the time that I have students who like wouldn't do the not P column because they're way too cool for that. And they think they can just flip the truth value in their head while they're doing this conditional. It turns out that a lot of my students, if they don't write down every sub-step on a test or something, they tend to, in their truth tables, they tend to get sort of mixed up, or they forget what the value is. They flip the value. It's easy to do that. You think true, you write false. So it's best to take every part and break it down so you have a column to refer to, and I'll explain why when we get to the big daddy at the end right here. If you try to do everything in your head from P and Q to this guy, you could probably do it, but if you were under any sort of time pressure, you'd definitely run the risk of making a mistake. So for this conditional right here, if Q then not P, I want you to look at the useful stuff over here. These two we're going to use in this bigger compound proposition, but you should have this one memorized. That's the basic conditional truth table. And it turns out that in the conditional statement, the only time that statement is false is when the premise is true and the conclusion is false. So the hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false. So that's really easy to sort of figure out, because look, I have the hypothesis here as Q, and then I have the conclusion here that's not P. So the only time that we have this case where you have the hypothesis is true and the conclusion is false is right here, okay? So that's the only place that I'm gonna get a false. The rest, I don't even have to think about. As long as it's not true false, it's gonna be true. Now, here's a biconditional, and it's our first one we've talked about so far. I'm going to use this useful stuff as sort of my cheat sheet for this problem. Again, I would have this memorized. Notice that P, if and only if Q is true, exactly when P and Q have the same truth value. Okay, and so that's what that cheat sheet tells you. And so it turns out that all I have to do is look over in these two columns. Here's my P and Q, and that's going to be true because they have the same truth values. They're different here. P and Q have different truth values here in this row, but they have the same value here. All right. Now here's the nice thing. We're one step away from finishing this problem, and we're just going to use this basic truth table in order to solve that last step. We just have to think of this as a new P and this as a new Q. Okay. So in this case, as we said, our new P and our new Q, if it's a biconditional, are true exactly when both truth values are true or both truth values are false. So they gotta have the same truth value for this new P and this new Q. Okay. So, and maybe you can think about it this way. A, if and only if B. A and B, since we're dealing with P's and Q's, and it's sort of an abusive notation for me to talk about the new P or the new Q. All right, so in this case, A and B have the same truth values. Oh, well, here, so that's got to be true down here. Well, they're different here, they're different here, and they're different here. And my cheat sheet over there under useful stuff, of course, tells me those must be false. So there you have it. Because we broke down this fairly confusing compound proposition into its sort of atomic parts, we were able to quickly use basic truth tables to solve this problem and write the truth table for this big ugly beast.